Welcome guys, in this video I'm going to build a age calculator GUI application using Python. And in Python I'm using a tkinter library of Python, which is a very beautiful library for creating any GUI application. So let's get started. So for this I'm using a Atom text editor. You can use IDLE also. I'm using Atom text editor. So this is my Python file hcal.py, which I build, and then let's get started to build age calculator GUI application. So initially we have to import some libraries. So first of all, from tkinter import star. Okay, it means from tkinter import everything. Okay, and then from tkinter import ttk. From tkinter module I am importing ttk class. Okay, and one more library I have to import date time. This module will help to get current date. Okay, and then from date time we have to import one more module, import date. From date time we have to import date class. Okay, and to show our result in the form of message box, from tkinter library we have to import message box. Message box will help to show our result in the form of message. And now let's get started to make our application window first. So I am assigning a new variable root and giving it a tk, t small k. Okay, and one thing I want to explain in this tutorial, that if you are using IDLE then you don't have to write this command, but if you are using any other text editor then you have to use this. So root dot main loop. So if you are using IDLE then you don't need to write this, but if you are using any other text editor then you have to write this to show your GUI, because everything I am going to build is inside this root.main loop. Okay, let's hit save and let's see our result. hcal.py. Okay, so here you see that my application window is built, and first of all I have to change its name from tk to age calculator. So we can do this by writing root dot title and age calculator. Okay, and now we can see Python hcal.py. Here you see. Now my application window is renamed to from tk to age calculator. Okay, and now let's set some geometry of my application window. So root dot geometry is something roughly I'm setting this still. So 200 cross 200 plus 300 plus 150. Let's see. Okay, that's quite good. At last I will set it. Here I want to tell you that in geometry I am using 200, and this is small x, then 200 plus. This is 200, this is the height and width, And this is the 300 and 100. What does it mean? It means 300 from x-axis here. This is x and y-axis. From 300 from x-axis and 150 from y-axis. So set our application window background by using root dot configure. And here I am using background attribute. Background equal to aqua. That's my favorite color. Okay. Let's see the output. hcal.py. Oh, it's a aqua color. Nice. Now let's get started by building some entries and labels. So first of all, I'm going to create a label equal to ttk.label, and here root is the first attribute, that is our application window, and then second attribute is text inside that label. What is the text? Then here I am using hcalculator, first label, calculator. Okay, and my label is generated, but before going for output, we have to set its geometry. So in this I am using grid. Here you see in label we have pack grid. There is two classes. If we are using pack, then our output will be one after another. And if you are using grid, then it is like a row and column format. Then in this I have to use grid. So, and make sure you can use only one of this. If you are using pack, then you can only use pack, and if you are using grid, then you can use grid. Okay, then label.grid is equal to, then we have to give row equal to 0, it means 0th row, and column equal to 1. Okay, hit save and see the result. Here you guys see that if I am using pack, then it takes all this space and each calculator is printed, and then if I am using next level, then it comes at the bottom of this. But if I am using grid, then it is divided in rows and column. This is first row, 0th row, the rows start with 0th, and it is in 0th column, but here I am using first column because I want to centralize it. I will show you something. I am building my application like that. That first of all, I am going to print age calculator, then there is a name label, and then name entry, and then date of birth, day, month and year, and then its entry. Then so I have to build it by using two columns and name entry 1, and column name entry, day entry and month entry, and year entry, that is date of birth, and then at last button. So I'm going to build like that, and now I'm going to use name entry. Name is equal to ttk dot label. root and text equal to name. Okay, text equal to name, and then we have to set its geometry name dot grid. That is going in row 0 and row 1. Row 0 is occupied by age calculator and column 0. Okay, and then I have to create name entry. Okay, name entry is equal to ttk dot entry, capital E entry. Okay, and here I am going to give root as first argument, and then in entry I am going to give nothing, and with we have to set its width. That is, entry is a box in which I am going to enter our inputs. So I gave it 20. Name entry is equal to okay, and then we have to set its geometry name entry dot grid, and it will be in row 1 and column 1, row 1 and column 1. Okay, let's save and see the result. So you guys see here, this is my row 0, this is row 0 and column 1, and this is row 1 and column 1. Like that I am using row 2 row 3 row 4 row 5 to give my year, month and day. Okay, so like that create another label of year equal to let's copy this. And change this file here. And here also. Here. And let's copy this. And change here year dot grid, and this will come in row 2 and column 0. Okay, this will come in row 2 and column 0, and now I'm using year entry equal to ttk dot entry. First argument is root, our application, main application window, and second argument will be width, which is same as 20, and then we have to set its geometry here entry dot grid, and in grid I am using now row is equal to 2 and column is equal to 1, first column. Like this we are going to build another label entry. So year entry is generated, and then and now month. In month we have to give text is month. Text is month, and here month, and it is in third row and zeroth column. Oh, here you have to set it label. It is label, month label, and then month entry we have to set. Month entry equal to ttk dot entry, and first is root as first argument, and then width equal to 20, and then month entry dot grid. Month entry dot grid is equal to row is equal to 3, and column equal to 1. Let's save and see the result, whether we are correct or anything wrong. So it's good. Yeah, it's good, but here y is small, we have to change it to capital. Everything is okay. Now our name is set, and name entry is set, and year, month, and now day. So similarly, create day entry first day label root comma text equal to date date, and then date entry is equal to ttk dot entry. Same step by using ttk dot entry and label method, we have to do same step as above. So here width is equal to 20, and then we have to set its geometry again by using grid, and here we are going to give row is equal to 4. This will come in fourth row. This will come in fourth row, and column is equal to 1. Here one thing I have missed, I will not set date geometry. Date dot grid, row is equal to 4, comma column is equal to 0. That's good. We have set all the things. Hit save and see the result. .py. Here we can see that this entry is created: name entry, year entry, month entry, and date entry. What is the date? Okay. Now we have to create one button with which, on clicking that button, we will get our age in the form of message. So we have to create one button. After writing our date, month, and year of, that is DOB, then after clicking that button, we have to make our GUI application like that after clicking that button, there is message print out with age, that you are 20 year old, 25 year old. So to create a button, you have to do same step like you are using in on creating label and entry. So to create a button, you have to use some step. So let's name it hcal equal to ttk dot button. Everything after ttk, that is every method, has first letter as capital. You see here ttk dot label capital L, and here ttk dot entry capital E. So everything after ttk is capital. Please note this. and then we will give same root as first argument, and then text equal to calculate age. This is the text on my button, and then set its geometry age cal dot grid, and give it row is equal to 5 and column equal to 1. We will give here column is equal to 1 so that it comes in between. Column is equal to 1 here, and hit save and see the result. Python hcal.py. Okay, let's see. That's good. But here one thing you have noticed, that when I'm extending my application window, then my entries and labels are static. They are not extending, they are not expanding and collapsing with it. They are not fit, they are not stick with it. So to stick our labels and entry with application window, we have to do some step, we have to use some commands. So to stick that, we have to use sticky argument we have to use. So first of all, I want to give some padding in my entries and label. So let's give some padding, because they are very close to each other. So give some padding. So let's give pad x equal to 3 and pad y equal to 3. I think this padding will beautify our GUI. So let's copy this in every grid function. Let's copy this in the geometry of every label and entry. So here I am copying it and paste. Copy paste. Let's copy this in every geometry of label and entry. I think it's okay. And then month, and that's fine. That looks good. Okay, hit save and see the result. hcal.py. That's good. Okay, now we have to do some more steps, and after that we have to perform a sticky function we have to use. So let's add one more argument in between this. So let's add sticky equal to south, north, east, west. This is SNEW, south, north, east, west. This is the work of sticky. We have to use it. Sticky is equal to south, north, east, west. Okay, paste it in every geometry of label and entries. So here copy paste everywhere. And now guys, after doing this, your application will be sticky with the application window, and but it will not move, it will not stretch, if you hit save and see the output, then it doesn't make any sense. HCl, if we increase, then you see here this tick, but it is not moving. So to solve this, we have to add some more methods. So let's add root dot row configure, root dot row configure, and which row we have to configure? Zeroth row, and weight, we have to give weight is equal to 1. What does it mean? It means we want to configure our row 0 with weight 1. It means if we increase our application window size, then it also increase with the same. If we use here weight is equal to 2, then if we increase our application window size, then our row 0 will increase with twice of that size which we are increasing in application window. So here I am using 1, so that our application window will increase. If our application window will increase with 20 pixel, then our main GUI application, GUI level and entries will also increase. Row 0 will also increase with 20 pixel. Okay. Similarly, this method we have to apply in all rows and column. So let's copy this and copy paste, and only change here row 0, row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4, row 5, and row no enough. And here we have to configure our column also. Column configure, here also column configure, we have to use column configure and configure our column. That's okay. So we have configured our all rows 0 1 2 3 4 5. Our level and entries is from 0th row to 5th row, and here I have configured all 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and here comma is missing, and with weight 1, that if we increase our application window, then our levels and entries inside row 0 to row 5 and in column 0 and column 1 will also increase with the same size. Okay, hit save and see the result. hcal.py. Okay, that's good, I think. So here you see that our labels and entries are also increasing with same size, as with our application window. It is tick. So it is done, and now we have to add some more thing to make our GUI application looks better. So here change it to 320 to 260. I think now it will looks better. Let's save and see. Python hcal.py. That's good. It looks now better. And now everything is done, and now we have to the work of button, so that after clicking that button, the message is shown that your age is this. So let's add some functionality of button. show to add functionality, we have to define a function age calculator. We have to define one function, and now we are going to use this date time module. Now there is use of this, and to calculate our age we need the current date, and then we need our date of birth, so we are going to calculate it. So first of all, let's define one variable named current date. Current date is equal to, we have to store the current date inside current date variable. Okay, current date is equal to, we have to use date time module date time dot date method, and in which we have to import current year. So we use date time dot date time dot now function, date time dot now, and then dot year. This will give the current year. This will give the current year, which will import the current year from our PC. And then we have to add a date time dot now dot month. We have to add month, and then, you know, date of birth is in the form of date, month and year. So now we have to add a day, date time dot date time dot now dot day. So now here you see that current date is equal to date time dot date method will give in argument, as we take current year is taken by using it date time dot now and dot year, and then date time dot now dot month, we will calculate the current date. We will extract the current date from our PC, and then date time dot now dot day, it will give the current day, current month and current year. And now we have to take date of birth. So to take date of birth, we have to use some function which can extract the entries given by user in our GUI application. That is here, name entry, name doesn't matter. Here the year entry and month entry and date entry. Here we are using these three entries: year entries, month entry and date entry. We are going to extract the values given in this entry, in this date of birth. So to extract this, we have to use some function. So first of all, we have to add date time dot date. Date time dot date. This module, this function will change it in the form of day, month and year. That is DDMMYY, in the form of DDMMYY. So we have to use this function, and then inside it, because as we know that everything given in the form in our entry is in the form of string, so we have to change it in integer. And then year entry dot get, we have to use this function, year entry dot get. this will take all the everything inside your entry. Similarly, we have to take month entry dot get. Similarly, date entry dot get, and here we have to change it to integer also. And here also we have to change it in integer form, because we are going to do subtraction, so we have to change it in integer. And then age is equal to, and then nothing to do, age is equal to round off. We can use round function, because I have to take the age in round manner. And age is equal to current date minus DOB. current date minus DOB. This will give, what does this mean? Date time dot date, after doing current date minus DOB, it will give everything in DDMMYY form. So we have to change in it in days. So to do this, we have to use days method. So now this date time dot date function, that is, after subtracting this, we get it in the form of DDMMYY form. So we have to use this function dot days to convert this in days. Now we are going to get everything in the form of days, our age in the form of days. So we have to divide it with 365.245 to get a accurate result, 2425, because 1 year is equal to 365.245 days. Now we get our date, our age in the year. So that's all. Now we have to use message box library will help us to show everything in the form of message. So message box dot show info, we will using here show info, and our title is age. It is shown at the top of the message box. And what is the message? Message equal to UR-YearOld dot format. Here we are using dot format, and here age. Then in message box there is message box title as age, and message is showing you are curly braces placeholder of format method, and here it is age. We can pass here age. Then message, in message box there is a message generated that you are the age calculated here as -year-old. Okay, that's all. Complete this project. And one more thing I have to add here, hcal.config. I'm using config function, hcal.config. Why we are using this? Because we have defined this function is defined here, but it is not connected with this hcal button. So hcal.config here we have to give command is equal to age calculator. We will pass the function age calculator, no parenthesis, hcal.config in bracket command is equal to age calculator. This finishes our button functionality, and now we can get our age. So hit save and see the result. Python hcal.py. Okay, let's enter the name. Okay, this is 1999 and month is 12 and age date is 10, and then calculate age. Let's see, you are 21 year old. This is my title, age. This is the title of message box, and this is the message generated. You are 21 year old. My age is calculated. So guys, let's style something. So to do some styling, now I am going to style this GUI application. So first of all, I have to create one variable. Style is equal to, I am using ttk.style method, and then we have to use some themes. Style dot theme use, I am using here, you can see by printing style dot theme use, and you can see the current theme and the theme list also, but here I am using clam. This is the theme you can use, and also some styling on button we have to do. Style.configure t button as first argument. What is t button? Is the class of button, and for label there it is a class of t label, like that in entries, for entries there is a class t entries. So t button is the class for button. We have to pass this so that our styling will done on only button, not on label, not on entries. Our styling will done only on button. So we have to pass this. And then the second argument we have to pass is background. Background is equal to, here I am going to give a background of red. And foreground, we have to give foreground is the text color of the button. Just button text is here button text is calculate age, so calculate age color will be here, will be defined by giving foreground, f-o-e-r-e, foreground is equal to blue, red and blue combination are about. So blue, and also I'm going to give some more style dot configure t label, like that t button, it is t label. This is for only label. We are going to style only label. So here I am going to give font in the form of tuple. So font is string Arial, and second argument is approximately, I think 13 will be good. 13 is the size of our text, size of our label text, and it is the Arial. It is of Arial text style, and hit save and see. Oh, that's cool. One more thing I am going to add, so that on hovering it we can get a new color. Style.map. Here we can use style.map to make our some hovering effect. So style.map and background, in which we have to give background. I am going to give background is equal to in list form, and then in tuple form background is equal to when it is pressed, when button is pressed. Then I am going to give green, and also when button is disabled. No disable, because my button is always enabled. So here this will what do, I'm going to show you that when our button calculate age button will be pressed, then it colors in green. See, I have not entered everything or anything, but see here, generate a green color. So I think that's all for this. Everything is done. So guys, that's all the code. And here you see that I want to give a summary of this video. That here initially I have imported a tkinter module, and then from tkinter I have imported ttk library, and then I have imported date, time and message box. From tkinter I have also imported message box, and then I have defined a variable root which contain our root, which is the root, which is the main window. And also I have also given a root.main loop, and it is not necessary if you are using idle text editor, but if you are using another other than idle, then you have to use this root.main loop. And then I have defined its title age calculator. My main window title is age calculator, and its geometry like that, and then its configuration, its background aqua, background is aqua color. And then label, first label is age calculator, and then these are its geometry, label geometry, and then name label like that. I have generated name label, and then name entry, date entry, age cal is the button. I've generated with text as calculate age. Everything is similar. If you have learned that from this, if you have learned that ttk.label, ttk.entry and ttk.button, only three thing are using, and one more thing is grid, which is for geometry. And here I am using sticky is only that our application is fit according to application window, or label and entries are fitted according to our window. If we increase our window size, then our labels and entries will also increase. So I am using this. And concept of geometry I would like to explain you here by showing you output. So concept of geometry is that here I am dividing my whole GUI application in two parts, rows and columns. This is rows and this is column. This is 0th row, 1st row, 2nd row, 3rd row, 4th row, 5th row, and this is 0th column and 1st column. And in 1st column you see here, you see here in zeroth row, and first column there is each calculator label, and then our name label is in first row and zeroth column, and then our name entry, this is name entry, this is in first row and first column, name entry is in first row, first column. And similarly, our year level is in second row and zeroth column, and like that it is. And now at last our button is at 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th row and first column, 0, 1, first column. And here I've given this pad X, pad Y. What does it mean? Pad X means padding in X direction. Pad Y means padding in Y direction. This is the pad X, pad Y. Pad Y means. And what does the meaning of sticky? Sticky is, so with the help of sticky, our GUI application is stick with our application window. And also by using this command, this all command, because by using 0th row, 1st row, 2nd row, 3rd row, 4th row, 5th row and 0th column and 1st column, and weight is equal to 1, means if we increase our application window, then our labels and entries will also increase with the same size as we are increasing our application window. So that's all this means, and this is our functionality in which I have given a age calculator function, in which I have defined age calculator function, in which current date time dot date will, what does it mean? Date time dot date function will generate everything in the form of DD MM YY form, date, month and year form. And here date time dot now dot year will generate the current year by importing it from our PC, and date time dot now dot month will import the month and current day. And here I'm using day, okay. And date of birth, date time dot date, and then date time dot date. And to explain you one more thing, date time dot date will take argument, date time dot date will take our first argument as year, second argument as month, and third argument as date. What is current date? 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 30, 31. So due to this, I have entered year entry first and then month entry, then date entry. And here before this, you will see here also year entry is first, then month entry, then day entry. Like that I have also entered here, because date time dot date function will take in this order, YY, MM and DD form, okay. And then I have subtracted current date with date of birth, and then I have used a days dot days function, so that this whole subtraction, which is in the form of date time dot date, is now converted in days. And then I have divided by 365.245, and then after using round function we get the current age in the form of integer. And then by using this message box function, message box dot show info, and title is message box title age, and message equal to this, you are the current age, year old. And this is some styling of tkinter GUI application. This is some styling, themes, clamp, and here I have also selected a button color. So my application, so this was the output. And now here if I type anything, an image, and year 1999 and month 12 and date 10, then after clicking calculate age, the message displayed, you are 21 year old, and this is the title of the message box, age. So this is the small project on tkinter पाइथन टी के इंटर लाइब्रेरी. सो गाइस, इफ दिस इज हेल्पफुल फॉर यू देन प्लीज लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब एंड ऑल्सो शेयर दिस वीडियो. थैंक यू गाइस, थैंक्स अ लॉट फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो.